All right, so that's working. I popped on over here to the War Thunder website when I was doing some of my pacing, and I saw that there was an RAF 100 to celebrate 100 years for the Royal Air Force. And I was like, oh, hey, usually when they do this sort of event, there's some special collectible. And I was right, there is a special collectible. So I scrolled down and I was like, oh, okay, well, what's going on here? Oh, Royal Tournament? You've got to be fucking kidding. But then I scrolled down a little bit further and I saw that it's not exactly the same as the classic tournaments, but it's not exactly 100% yet. But if they, if, okay, I don't want to speak too early because the last time Gaijin, when they started doing these awful tournament events, be X player or whatever, they actually started to change it in a way that I was able to work with. And I actually said, okay, this is an improvement. So now everybody has an opportunity, depending on their skill level, to actually take part and possibly get the vehicle. Then they went straight back into the garbage can with the tournaments again. And now it looks like they're doing that same thing where they're repeating by actually trying to make it a little bit different, where now everybody, based on your skill, will still have an opportunity to get the vehicle. There is no be X player, be top player, or anything like that. By the end of the tournament, none of that bullshit. Instead, you have there is one catch. You only have 60 matches. That's it. If you cannot do what is required in 60 matches, you're out of the ball game. But I still don't like that. I still think that's a million times better than the classic, only 100 players get to walk away with the vehicle, at least in my opinion. All right, so they're doing another event. Can we slow down? Today was supposed to be Finnish Far Cry 5 Day. Apparently not anymore. So what's up for grabs exactly? A special Spitfire F Mark 9C. Now this, at first when I saw this, I said, okay, another Mark 9. Great. We already have a premium version of that on the British tech tree. We have a premium American. We have a premium Russian one. We have one on the standard tech tree for the Great British, but. What? Why this one? Well, the image—they don't exactly give information on here, but if you look at the image, it looks like it actually has four 20mm cannons. So a Spitfire Mark 9 with four cannons is, significantly different to what we're usually used to. And in that case, I am definitely interested. So here we go, from 12 GMT on the 6th of April to 9 GMT on the 9th of April. So only that's less than 3 days that you have to do this. It's about 2 days and something. You have the opportunity to play 60 matches. You can win and get an RAF centenary, I guess, a decal and the main prize, a coupon for a premium Spitfire F Mark 9C, which is a rank 3 premium. Now here's how it works. So the pilot who scores the first 6 shoots shoot shoots shoot okay, let me restart. The pilot who scores the first 6 air kills will win. That's it. So it's a free for all, so there is no good or bad team. It's a free for all, and whoever gets the first 6 kills wins. Now you don't get the plane for winning, but here's how it works, okay? You can set up your own Spitfires in advance, or you can use the preset lineups, which are unmodified and novice crews. These are the available aircraft you can use. You can use the Spitfire Mark 2B, the Spitfire Mark 5B, the Spitfire F Mark 9, and the Spitfire LF Mark 9. That's it. It's up to you to choose and play them however you want in any order. So you have 4 total spawns that you can use. For one victory in any tournament game mode, you will receive the decal, which can be seen right here. So this is a decal you get for winning once. So that's nice. Okay, one win, you get a little shit for it. For each victory in any tournament game mode, for one victory you get one decal. Then for every victory you will get 50,000 silver lions. So that's also not bad. However, for the indicated number of wins in one of the available modes, you will receive the Spitfire F Mark 9. So what does that mean? Well, there's arcade, realistic, and simulator. So to get the plane, you have to get 12 wins in arcade battles. If you want to get the plane for realistic, you need 9 wins, and you need 6 wins for simulator battles. So that means you have to be the first person to get 6 kills, okay? The first person to get 6 kills 12 times in arcade. It's 12 of 60 matches, so you got to get 6 kills first before anyone else, because that's when the match is over, I'm assuming. You do that 12 times, you get the plane. Or you do that 9 times, you get the plane in realistic. Or you do that 6 times in simulator, you get the plane. That's how it works. It's based off of skill. For the first time in tournament history, there's no bullshit here. There is no you know, crappy RNG win system or anything going on. You actually have to get in the game yourself, get kills, and be the first one to six, and you'll be done in a free-for-all match. That is definitely an improvement to the tournament system. If we can keep doing that for these collectible vehicles, maybe I can start taking back all of the bad words I have used towards Gaijin Entertainment when it comes to their tournament decisions. Let's scroll down here. Here are the terms and conditions. A coupon for the Spitfire F Mark 9C can be received only once. So you can't go, you can't win 24 matches in arcade and get two Spitfires or something like that. So you can either sell it or you can equip it. You can sell the coupon on the market, as you would assume. So that means you are going to be able to buy it as well. Which, hopefully I get this, because I have $1.57, I think, in my War Thunder market left over. To take part in it, it is required that a ticket is purchased, so you have to buy a tournament ticket for 50,000 Silver Lions from the in-game item shop for any of the game mode that you wish to participate. You will not be able to play more than 60 battles in each game mode. Okay, so it says more than 60 battles in each game mode, so I guess that means, I don't know if that means you can only play 60 battles and that's it, or you have 60 battles per game mode. So if you don't get it in the arcade, you can play another 60 battles in realistic. I don't know how that works. They don't specify, so there you go. For participation, you need to research and purchase at least one of the tournament aircraft, so you have to own one of them. So if you own just, I guess, one of them, you're good to go. Each pilot who clicks on the participate button will bring in a prize fund of 10,000 Silver Lions. Don't know what that means, but it's a tournament, so. Victories in multiple game modes will not be counted towards the total. We recommend choosing a single. Yeah, so you can't, like, you can't win four times in arcade and then win twice in realistic. They're going to be completely separate. You have to win the total number of times in that particular game mode. So pick one, go with it. Arcade looks like the hardest, because you have to get the most wins. But I don't know how realistic works. I don't know if you all spawn in the air and you do it that way. I'm not exactly sure. But there you go. That's a thing. And they are also putting on a special bundle sale for a bundle with 30% discount and vehicles for Golden Eagles. So here you go. Some of these are collectibles. So collectibles is in there, not sold on the store anymore. So if you want them, you better get your ass in here and get them. From 12 GMT on 6th of April to 9 GMT on the 9th of April, again, you can buy a bundle pack, His Majesty's Finest, which will include Prendergast Spitfire FR Mark 14 E pack, fantastic Spitfire premium. You'll get the Wyvern pack, the MB5, that's the new pack, and you'll also get a special title known as His Majesty's Finest. And in-game, you can purchase 4 Golden Eagles. You can get the Spitfire LF Mark 9C, which is the not canon version, not the 4-can, not the one you're collecting here in the event. This is Plagueis Spitfire, another very good premium. And you can also get the classic OG Typhoon Mark 1B premium, which I didn't even know was removed from the store. So there you go. And PS4 players will be able to receive the His Majesty's Finest title by simultaneously purchasing the Prendergast Spitfire FR Mark 14E and Typhoon Mark 1B packs for Golden Eagles in the same transaction. Alternatively, players can already have both of these vehicles or purchase the missing one during the event. In this case, you will just need to relog to the game and you will get the title as well. And there you go. Bish, bash, bosh. Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your auntie, and you're done. I really did want to finish Far Cry 5 today. That's why I had planned it. I had gotten sleep. You know, I mean, I don't have food. I've got a Butterfinger. That's all I've got to push me through it. Now I have to play more of this fucking game. I just got off the big grind for the Tiger Tank, and now I have to do it again, but not as bad this time. God damn it. Bloody hell. Just give me a break. I need a break, please. Apparently not. I guess we're going to be doing this. Here's some history on the Air Force if you want. Anyways, guys, good luck to anyone taking part in the event. Remember, again, you've got 60 battles at least to get the total number of wins to get the plane. So there's no top player. It's all based on your own skill. If you don't get it in the 60 battles, it's going to suck, and I honestly am worried that I'm going to be part of that group. But, you know, at least it was a fair event this time around, as far as I can tell. I don't see any discrepancies here that seem a little bit fishy to me. We'll have to see, though, once we actually get in. I'll see you guys in the air, probably. And, yeah. Boy, I'm scared.